Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi Taihutu. Today, again, two videos, one TA video, one really cool family video, but I will tell you more about it in the end of this video. Let's quickly jump into the charts, because you all want to know what is happening with Bitcoin, why did we crash, what is going to be next, how did it all happen. I'm going to give you a short TA video. So let's jump into the chart so I can explain to you what I think that is happening, and maybe you agree with me or not. Just comment down below that video. Let's jump into the first chart. Let's jump into this one. Bam. This is the 4-hour chart, guys. On this 4-hour chart, you can see that we expected this huge wave 5 to the upside, this one. And we saw a bull flag pattern and we thought we were going to break out. But sometimes in this industry, things happen that we can't predict, like thousands of hashing power in China that drops out. And then you crash, bam, the Bitcoin price crashes with 10K candles, all the way to 50K, coming back. And we need to create a new pattern at that moment. This pattern, we don't know yet. Let's see how strong the market is in like rebouncing. We did rebounce, and we can see out of the rebounds, we are forming this new channel, in my opinion. You know, we can use the bodies, or we use the wicks, we can do both like this. And you can see that we are moving inside this channel. I believe that we are going up again, and that we are going to go into the old channel, into that pattern that we were forming, you know, and then we start to move again in that upward channel to the upside. If we zoom into the 15-minute chart, we can see the same thing is happening. I need to zoom out a little bit. So this is the channel. I need to make it a little bit bigger like this. So fit it a little bit. So you can see, you know, we were at the bottom, we came above, and then, you know, you go up, you try to break this resistance, you come down, and then you start to form this new pattern, and this pattern is moving in this channel nicely upway. If you find support here around 56, we will slowly go again to 59. This is all, we don't have a glass ball, no crystal ball, no, nothing. We see the 200-day moving average here, we want to break that one, we want to be above that line again and then find that line of support. If we look at the 4-hour again back, we can see the 200 is near as well. You see this red line here, this is the 200-day moving average. I hope you see my pointer, because sometimes it just disappears. I'm going to do this from here. So we are moving in this channel, and this line, the red line over there, that is the one we want to break, the 200-day moving average, $58,000. And when we break that, we go above it, and maybe retest it again, and then we go up. This is all speculating, guys. We don't know for sure, but I'm going to show you what we can do. We can look at history. And when we look at the history, we can see what happened during this bull market. Yes, we are in a bull market. So let's jump into the most exciting chart for me, that shows you exactly what we did before and what I expect that we will do next. Okay, let's jump into the chart. That is, bam, this chart. I created this chart this morning. I'm going to switch to the cross. And in this chart, I want to show you guys that during this bull run, an average dip of 24% led to an average run of 58%. So what do you expect that is next? We saw the first dip from here, the level of 41,900, we dipped with 30%, bam, down to the level of 28, huge dip. That was the perfect level to buy the dip, because we saw a run after from 41 to all the way up, or from $28,000, sorry, all the way up to 57. That was a 102% run. Then we saw another dip. We dipped from 58, bam, all the way down to 42. That was a 26.5% dip. If you would have bought that dip, you will have joined the run of 44%, all the way up back to $63,000. Then again, we saw a dip. 63, bam, all the way down to 50. That's a $12,000 to $13,000 dip. That's a 20% dip. If you would have bought that dip around 50, you would have had another beautiful run all the way up to 65. That's a 28.8% profit if you bought the dip. And what did we see happening now? We dropped from 65, bam, all the way to 51. That's a 20% drop. That's $13,360, bam, down. What do you expect next after this 20% dip? If we look back at the history, in average, we dipped 24%. And the run after that in average was 58%. So if the average run would now happen after this dip, we would go all the way up here to $80,000. That is, if we repeat what happened in history during this bull market. So if we would take the average dip and the average run, we would need to see a 58% run, and that would go up to 80K. If we calculate the other way, from 100% run to a 40% run, let's say divided by 2, to a 28% run divided by 2, let's say we divide that one by 2 to a 14% run, let's see where we get then. Then we would end up somewhere, and that's almost not possible, but because then we would end up somewhere here, you see? Then we would end up at 59, around 60K. All possibilities. Again, we can't predict the future. We don't have a glass ball, but we can see what happened in the past. And in the past, during this bull run, an average run of 58% happened. So if we would go to the target on the 4-hour chart, you know, and that is the target, if we go back to this chart that we already drew here, you know, this one, the fifth wave, that would be around like $67,000 to $70,000. So if we would need to come to that target, we need to do a run of exactly, let's see, here. We need to do a run of 38%. Look at the other runs. We did those kind of runs. We can do it again. We can go above 70K. So that is what I expect of the market to happen. I hope you really understand how I think about this. And I want to make very clear to you guys that this is not the top of the bull run. We are not crashing to zero. And why don't I think this? Because if you look at my Twitter today, yes, I get more and more followers on Twitter. I tweet a lot. We can see that serious strong-handed Bitcoin holders are buying this dip. In the last 24 hours, over 200,000 Bitcoin became illiquid. Not $200,000 worth of Bitcoin, 200,000 Bitcoins. That's a 3-year record. Illiquid means that people are moving their Bitcoins from the exchanges into hardware wallets or whatever, not using them anymore to trade. A 3-year record. More than 200,000 Bitcoins removed from the liquidity of exchanges. That's a huge number, guys. That's a 3-year record. People are not willing to sell their Bitcoins. This shows you that really strong-handed Bitcoin hodlers are hodling the Bitcoins. And when they hodl the Bitcoins, they don't expect the top of the bull market to be in. When they start to decrease the hodlings and move their Bitcoins again back to the exchanges, that is the moment that the bull run is coming to the top. So please understand this. Guys, one more time. If you want to trade the Bam Bam indicator, the TikTok indicator, all the indicators that we provide, soon also again the BFAT, the free indicator, then please use these referral links, because at the moment we have a special offer on Bybit. Yes, I wrote Bybit wrong in there, but Bybit is giving you a $1,610 bonus, up to $1,610 bonus. I need to be very clear with this. So you can claim up to $1,610 by using this special link. It's an exclusive link, the Bybit DD Bonus Bash, $1,000 in deposit, $100 in rewards hub and a $500 referral program. So if you want to sign up to Bybit today, do it today, because today this bonus is active when you use my special referral link, this one over there, guys. That was everything for today. That was my short video for today. Really short video. I think I can see the minutes somewhere around 10 minutes again. Maximum it reached. But please understand, it's not the end of the bull market in my opinion. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just a Bitcoin dude that holds his Bitcoins, wears a Bitcoin Marley, Bob Marley t-shirts on beaches and has a little bit of experience into this market and can analyze the charts for you. I hope you really appreciate what I'm doing for you on my days that I normally could also zip cocktails on the beach. I hope you appreciate it. If you appreciate it, please give this video a thumbs up, share with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, please leave a comment down below the video. What do you think about these dips and these runs that we see after? And please always remember to sometimes zoom out in Bitcoin and zoom in at life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, as that is exactly what life should be about. Thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you will enjoy the second video today, the family video. It involves another Bitcoin family. It involves a very big animal, and it involves water, and it involves education of the kids. You will love it. Thanks for watching this one. Enjoy the next one, and see you all tomorrow again. Bam!